Hi, welcome to Sanctuary Lighting Part 2, an introductory information series about getting you started in the task of procuring a lighting system for your house of worship. I'm Dan Tulloch, a sales representative specializing in sanctuary lighting here at Christie Lights Limited. Welcome to our second segment, Preparing a Lighting Synopsis. Here we are again at Queensway Cathedral, and we thank their technical management team for their support. First of all, the lighting synopsis is basically the list of lighting tasks that will be required in your unique worship space in order to provide illumination and also set atmosphere conducive to your worship styles. Most people who volunteer or who get volunteered to investigate a lighting system for their house of worship usually know very little about lighting. To work with a lighting company effectively, when you get started, you don't really need to know anything about lighting. You just need to identify what you need the lighting to do. A lighting company representative or consultant will be able to figure out the technical equipment and lighting control from the details and information you have provided in the synopsis. So going forward, the first thing you need to do is examine your worship service and make a list of any locations or elements you need illuminated. Make sure to include as much detail as possible about the different items when making your list. For example, usually all worship services have a sermon or message segment presented by the pastor, priest, elder, or minister. The first item on your list will be your needs when illuminating the area on the sanctuary platform where the sermon takes place. Make sure to take note of what the blocking boundaries are as well. Here are a couple of examples of two very different situations. First of all, the sermon takes place from behind the podium or pulpit, and usually the presenter remains there for the entire sermon. The pulpit is located in the center of the stage. Example two, the sermon takes place in the center area of the stage, and the pastor is on a wireless mic and moves across the whole front of the stage area while speaking, but usually speaks most of the message from the center area. He occasionally moves down the stairs into the congregation to deliver some of his messages. From these notes, you have provided me with enough information to recommend a suitable lighting solution. In the first example, lighting the pulpit may require two or three fixtures, but lighting the area required in the second example would require more fixtures and possibly a more intricate control system. The details in your synopsis provide a basic understanding of the lighting requirements that you will need, and then the lighting consultant will be able to follow up with any questions to clarify details in order to get the perfect results in the final plan. Secondly, you would make a list of the area where other elements of your worship service take place on the platform. Other examples would be to include the location of the baptismal tank or font and describe exactly how that part of the service takes place. Include all other elements and features, for example, altars, communion tables, and secondary podiums for lay readers. These items need to be included in the list so the lighting consultant can get a quick overview of their requirements and then ask any appropriate questions they need to clarify their locations and size. The next part of the synopsis is describing how the musical elements are positioned on the platform. Musical elements vary immensely from church to church, denomination to denomination. Some houses of worship have musical directors who either play an instrument and sing in a praise band or conduct a choir. The lighting consultant needs to know in detail where all the musicians and performers are located. He needs to know if there is a conductor, as well as the size of the boundaries of the choir, or a loft, if applicable. Every musical element is usually as unique as the church itself, so the more detailed information you can provide in your list will ensure that all the needs are addressed. Do not leave any information out. It is better to have a full list of requirements and pare down to suit your final plan rather than leave any details out at this point. The lighting synopsis becomes the outline of the whole lighting specification and is your first step in preparing for the whole process. Once you as a client and I as a lighting supplier are all on the same page, the rest of the process moves forward very logically because we work out the technical solutions line per line till all the details in the synopsis are dealt with. from the original list, further discussion should arise so that the final version of the synopsis can evolve into the actual plan of the installation. In part three, I will give you an overview of the different types of lighting we choose for lighting the sanctuary platform. See you then.